Hello everyone, welcome to day 3 of Extended Victory. Let's read the...
You, Lord, are my lamp. The Lord turns my darkness into light. With your help, I can advance against a troop. With my God, I can scale a wall. As for God, his way is perfect. The Lord's word is flawless. He shields all who take refuge in him. For who is God besides the Lord? And who is the rock except our God? It is God who arms me with strength and keeps my ways secure. The Lord is with me. He is my helper. I looked in triumph on my enemies. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in humans. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes. All the nations... So do not throw away your confidence. It will be richly rewarded. You need to persevere so that when you have done the will of God, you will receive what he has promised. For...
God is not a tyrannical boss, but a loving father. First read 2 Samuel 22, 29-33, Psalm 118, 7-9, and Hebrews 10, 35-36. With God on our side, nothing is impossible for us. Even when seemingly insurmountable obstacles loom before us, God is our shield. We just have to trust him, and we can be sure that he will bless us. However, this does not mean that he will grant us all our wishes and that we will never encounter opposition. To do God's will, patience is sometimes necessary. In our impatience, however, we forget that God has a much better overview of our lives than we do, and instead believe that God will be favorable to us only if we do something in return. This image of God is shaped by our everyday lives, where we repeatedly experience, both professionally and privately, that something in exchange is expected of us when someone does us a favor. History is full of people who, in moments of fear, have proposed a deal to God that they thought would be attractive to God. But God doesn't want to get the best deal for himself. He has prepared the best possible deal for us, and his gifts are not attached to conditions. He doesn't just give us his goodness when we give money to charity or volunteer. He wants us to thrive and be a light for others. No matter how much we have been hurt in our past life, God can heal all wounds, we just need to allow him to work and trust him. No amount of money in the world can save us from emotional and physical pain. However, because money cannot buy us so many things, it can remind us that God blesses us anew every day. With success in our work, with friends who support us and above all with his unconditional love, which we could never buy or bargain for. We don't even need to, because he gives it to us just like that. Without a deal. Without anything in return. Prayer, get free, and next step. In what areas is your image of God shaped by your experiences and wounds? Go to the cross today and surrender those injuries.